Welcome to the second section of this institute. Our second section is related to types of ecosystem. So already in last session, we have learned concepts of ecology, then components of ecosystem and types of ecosystem such as natural and artificial ecosystem. So in this session, we will study in detail types of ecosystem, for example, forest, grassland, desert, pond, river, ocean, and estuaries. Forest ecosystem. These are ecosystems having a predominance of trees that are interspread with a large number of species of herbs, shrubs, algae, animals, birds, etc. So forests occupy roughly 40% of land. And if we consider India, the forest occupy roughly 1/10 of total land area. So next point is components of forest ecosystem. Okay, so again, ecosystem is divided between abiotic and biotic components. So the components of forest ecosystem are: abiotic components will be inorganic and organic substances which are present in soil. Climate. So if you consider climate, that climate is different for each type of forest ecosystem. For example, if forest is a coniferous, or it is a deciduous, or it is a tropical rainforest, so climate of all these types of forests will be different. Likewise, temperature, light penetration, okay. Even as a abiotic factors, minerals like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, these are also present in forest ecosystem. Next point is biotic factors. So biotic factors present in forest ecosystems are producers, consumers, and decomposers. So if you consider producers, so these are green plants, or we can say large trees which are present in forest. So example will be teak, oak, pine, sal, sandalwood, etc. Consumers. Consumers are again having various types, for example, herbivores such as deer, then carnivores such as snakes and fox, and if we consider tertiary carnivore, or we can say tertiary consumer, then it will cover lion and tiger. The last point is decomposers. So decomposers present in forest ecosystem will be fungi, bacteria. Okay, next ecosystem is grassland ecosystem. So basically, ecosystem whose dominant species are various types of grass is called as grassland ecosystem. So grassland ecosystem is dominated by grass species, but sometimes also low plants, or we can say growth of few trees or shrubs, are also allowed in grassland ecosystem. Again, grassland ecosystem is having various types, for example, tropical grassland, which is present near tropical rainforest. These are also called as savannas if we consider South Africa. Okay, even temperate grassland, that means which can grow on flat or gentle slope hills. Okay, and last will be polar grasslands. Okay, now we will see components of grassland ecosystem. Abiotic factors. So abiotic factors of grassland ecosystem will be much more similar to forest ecosystem. Now, biotic factors will be producers, consumers, and decomposers. So, as this is a grassland ecosystem, so in the case of producers, we will find mainly grasses, shrubs, and trees, and tall grass like bamboo. Consumers, if we consider in grassland ecosystems, will be cow, buffalo, sheep, lizards, hawk. And if we consider savannas, that is, which is present in Africa, even in India, so these savannas will have animals like giraffe, zebras, etc. Decomposers will be same, that is fungi and bacteria. Next ecosystem is desert ecosystem. So desert occupy about 17% of land occurring in the region of high temperature and low rainfall. So basically, desert ecosystem are characterized by having thin vegetation, and organisms that live in deserts are specially adapted to withstand water stress. So if we consider types of desert, that is tropical desert or cold desert. So tropical desert example will be Sahara in South Africa, and in India it will be Thar, Rajasthan. So if we consider cold desert, then example will be Gobi Desert in China, or if we consider Ladakh district in our India. Components. So abiotic components in desert ecosystem will be very high temperature, rainfall is very low, and nutrient cycle is very poor due to few biota available. Now biotic factors. So biotic factors will be again producers, consumers and decomposers. Producers will be grasses, shrubs and cacti like plants. Consumers will be reptiles, insects, birds and camel. Decomposers will be, as having high temperature, this region is having thermophilic bacteria, or we can say thermophilic fungi. Okay, next ecosystem is pond or lake ecosystem. So this ecosystem is related to aquatic ecosystem. Okay, so basically aquatic ecosystem is based in water, and basically if you want to again classify aquatic system as a freshwater or as a marine water, then it is again divided as a freshwater ecosystem will be divided into two types, which is called as lentic, that is standing water body, or lotic, which is running water body. And marine ecosystem will be classified as shallow coastal waters and deep waters. Okay, so first we will see pond or lake ecosystem. So pond is a good example of self-sufficient and self-regulatory system. So if we consider components in pond ecosystem, that will be first will abiotic components. So governing factors in abiotic components will be light, pH of water, temperature, then basic inorganic compounds like water itself, CO2, O2, nitrogen, carbon, etc. And biotic components, if you consider, then again producers, consumers and decomposers. So in producers, there will be a presence of phytoplankton that are nothing but sun-dependent free-floating organisms. Even macrophytes are also present as a producers, which are also called as free floating plants, which are partly or completely submerged under water. Consumers. Consumers will be zooplanktons, bacteria, small fish, insects, big fish like game fish, etc. And fish which are fed on herbivores. Then decomposers will be bacteria and fungi. Protozoa is also present in aquatic ecosystem. Next ecosystem we are going to study is river ecosystem. So rivers are large streams that flow downward from mountain. Okay. So basically rivers are more oxygenated due to large surface area that will absorb atmospheric oxygen into water. Now components of river ecosystem will be abiotic components will be lesser mineral content, high penetration of light, then elements like pH, dissolved oxygen is more, nitrate, phosphates and sulfates are also present in river ecosystem. Next is biotic component. So biotic components will be producers, first thing, which are nothing but slow flowing water algae and water grass. Consumers will be snails, worms, fish, crocodile, bird frogs, etc. Decomposers will be fungi, bacteria and protozoa. Next ecosystem is estuarine ecosystem. An estuary is a partially enclosed coastal area at the mouth of river where fresh water and salty seawater meets. Okay, so basically estuarine have a rich biodiversity, and if we consider components of estuarine ecosystem, that will be abiotic components will be salinity, DO, high nutrient, high minerals, etc. Biotic components will be producers, that is marsh grasses, sea grasses, then consumers will be oysters, crabs, shrimps, fish, and decomposers will be protozoa, bacteria, fungi, etc. Next ecosystem is ocean ecosystem, which is the largest ecosystem as 2/3 of Earth's surface is covered by ocean. So components of this ecosystem will be abiotic components, salinity, DO, minerals like iron, magnesium, etc. Even oils and natural gas we can consider it as a abiotic component. Biotic components will be producers as a phytoplanktons, diatoms, seaweeds. Consumers will be fish, fish-like shed, herring, cod, etc. Decomposers will be fungi and bacteria. So this is regarding various types of ecosystem. Thank you.